everybody. I hope you can see me and hear me. I've got the live stream pulled up on another screen, so just let me know that you can hear all right. It might be a little bit difficult to hear me speak. I promise the organ will be much louder than that. this is something new we're trying. There's a new app as of, I think, this last spring called Facebook Gaming, and that's actually how I'm streaming this live stream to you, so that I can show you on my screen exactly what I'm seeing, so that we can synchronize music and movie. So you could just write in the comments that you can hear all right. You might have to turn up the volume a little bit. Thank you. I see everybody joining. So good evening and welcome to tonight's silent film screening of the film Nosferatu. My name is Steven Seiger, and I'm proud to be the music director here at the Old Presbyterian Meeting House in historic Old Town Alexandria, Virginia. Tonight, I'll be playing our 1997 Tracker Action organ by Lively Fulcher. I would show you the keys and everything here and the pipes, but I'm afraid if I move my camera that I'll screw up this setup here. So just trust me that I'm actually playing. I'm sitting here at the organ bench. You can see behind us, beautiful chandelier and the rest of the church. So before we get started, I want to tell you a little bit about the film itself. But first, if you're joining us on Facebook Live again, just make sure to comment and let me know you're here, you're watching, and that you can hear everything okay. I'd also like to call your attention to the link in the description. This is a free concert, but if you feel so inclined, please consider donating to help defray the costs of this and future concerts. As you may know, the Meeting House recently upgraded our video and lighting equipment, and for our outdoor events, we also have purchased new portable sound equipment. So, a big change for us, but that's so that we can reach as many people as possible through our online worship that we offer on Sunday mornings and some of our outdoor, in-person, safely social distance services and other events. So, check out the link in the description and help show your support for our ongoing efforts. Streaming like this isn't new for concerts at the Meeting House. You may have joined us last month when we presented a concert of spirituals featuring our alto soloist, Elise Jenkins. But this one is just a little bit different because I'm sharing my screen here for you, and you'll get to see exactly what I'm seeing as the film gets started. But you'll be hearing our wonderful sound setup here of the organ. So that's pretty cool, huh? So tonight's film selection is Nosferatu. It's from 1922, and it's a cinematic masterpiece of German expressionism, directed by Friedrich Wilhelm Murnau, starring Max Schreck as Count Orlok, Gustav von Wangenheim as the estate agent Hunter, and Greta Schroeder as his wife Ellen. And there are many others in the film, but those are the main characters. It's an unauthorized and unofficial adaptation of Bram Stoker's Dracula, and the production company behind Nosferatu knew that, and they knew that they were inviting a lawsuit from Stoker's estate. So, of course, they declared bankruptcy shortly after the release to evade copyright and royalties. But it was the first real vampire film, before stereotypes of film vampires were cliché. So you'll notice some things used in subsequent vampire films, like that the vampire shuns sunlight, something not even found in Stoker's novel or in folklore. You also notice his bat-like ears and his claws. One big difference from this film and subsequent films, though, is his teeth. So I'll let you discover that for yourself. But they're not quite the canines that we normally see in modern vampire films. The film is technically a horror film, but not in the modern sense. It's not bloody, gory. It doesn't really have those jumpy moments like our modern horror films. Instead, as Roger Ebert said when he added this to his list of greatest films of all time, he says, quote, "I admire Nosferatu more for its artistry and ideas, its atmosphere and images, than for its ability to manipulate my emotions like a skillful modern horror film. It knows none of the later tricks of the trade, like sudden threats that pop up from the side of the screen. But Nosferatu remains effective. It doesn't scare us, but it haunts us. It shows not that vampires can jump out of shadows, but that evil can grow there, nourished on death." These are the features that I think make Nosferatu such an excellent silent film. The characters are confronted with all of the things that we lay awake at night dreaming about or thinking about. War, disease, madness, insanity, right? And yet they are denied the freedom, the characters in the movie, they are denied the freedom of being able to talk it away because it's a silent film. So to quote Ebert again, he says, quote, "Human speech dissipates the shadows and makes a room seem normal. Those things that only live at night do not need to talk, for their victims are asleep, waiting." As you probably know, the title silent film is a little bit of a misnomer. Silent films never were and were never intended to be silent. They were always accompanied by music. In the early part of the 20th century, organists and pianists alike trained to work for cinemas, studying the films, learning to improvise along with every move and every cliche. Some more well-known films came with cue sheets, a little piece of paper that had fragments of melodies that would accompany certain characters or scenes. Some even had full-fledged scores with orchestra. Nosferatu did have a full orchestra score by Hans Erdmann, but most of this is lost today. You'll hear some reconstructions of it, but mostly it's lost. There have been countless other scores, of course, for Nosferatu written over the years, though many, of course, were improvised and not transcribed. I contemplated myself writing a totally original from scratch soundtrack for Nosferatu, but I found early in my research a really interesting piece that I think not so many people know about. There's a suite of music that was inspired by this film and written in 2 years following its release by none other than American composer Aaron Copland. Unfortunately, too, this score exists only in fragments, since Copland himself retracted the piece. But it consists of about 20 minutes of music that he wrote while a student of Nadia Boulanger in Paris. Copland was a huge fan of film, and he's even written for some films you may have seen. So after seeing Nosferatu in the theater, he and his roommate, writer-director Harold Clurman, wrote a ballet based on this film. Copland said that this piece, which he called Grohg, G-R-O-H-G, if you want to look it up, was the most ambitious work of his Paris years, his student years. The music was intended to be morbid and excessive to meet the taste of the time for the bizarre. Copland also took this opportunity to use much more modern rhythms and dissonances than he had before in his need to provide gruesome events for the ballet. Some critics even called it Copland's Rite of Spring. But after playing the work with Nadia Boulanger, arranged for piano four hands at a party in 1924, Copland put the work away and did not release it for publication. Although he recycled some of the music in others of his later works, most notably his dance suite for orchestra, and interestingly enough, also his organ concerto, most of this music, however, is seldom heard. So my score tonight is a hybrid. It's a mixture of Aaron Copland's themes. And you'll hear the themes right away. At the very beginning, you'll hear Count Orlok's theme. You'll hear a little bit later Hutter's theme, Ellen's theme, their love theme, and of course, the music for Nock. And you'll understand who he is if you don't know the film in a little bit. So those are by Copland. All the rest of the music is by me, inspired by those themes. Hopefully you'll hear Copland peeking through here and there, but it's definitely not the Copland that you know and love from his kind of expansive American music that you know about. This is definitely inspired by his work with Nadia Boulanger. Again, thanks for joining us, and I'll see you on the other side. This movie's about 81 minutes long, so I hope you've got some popcorn there, and we'll get into the Halloween spirit with this movie. And again, check out the link if you'd like to donate. So, I'll see you on the other side. Enjoy Nosferatu.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, that's the end. I made it to the end. Hope you made it too. Hope there wasn't too many technical glitches there, that you heard everything. But thank you for watching Nosferatu tonight as part of our fellowship events. And again, if you would like to donate, just check the link in the description. I'm definitely tired out, so I'll see you another time. Thanks for watching. We'll post this as soon as I stop talking to Facebook and then to YouTube, so you can share it with everybody and watch it and rewatch it as many times as you want. Have a good night, everybody.